Hey, welcome back to another video. Today it's about Bitwig Studio 3.1 and the new... No, not the micro pitch. It's about the Pitch 12 modulator inside Bitwig Studio, how you can create chords and progressions with it. So let's start. If you want to save some money on Bitwig Studio and the upgrade plans, and you want to support my channel and my content, then go to my webpage, use the link to the Bitwig store there, use my code and save actually 5% on the regular price. Hey, welcome back. I already loaded up Contact 5 inside Bitwig Studio 3.1, and in front of the Contact 5, I have a multi-node device already set up. Inside the contact, I have the emotional piano loaded, and we also have an on-screen display where we can see which keys we are pressing actually. So the multi-node device is a pretty easy to understand device. It just takes one note and outputs multiple notes. So in this case here, we have only activated one line. We have no pitch offset, no velocity offset. And when we input a C key, a C note, we're also getting a C note as an output, so pretty easy. If we want two notes, we actually activate two lines, and we have a pitch offset here of 4 semitones. The second note that's played is 4 semitones above the input note. If we activate three, then we have three notes. To have a major chord, we need a sequence of 0, 4, and 7, as I already set this up here. And if you press C, you have a C major chord. If you press D, you have a D major chord. If you press E, you have an E major chord, okay? So pretty easy. To create a minor chord, we have to pitch this one semitone down. So when we press C now, we have a C minor chord. If you press D, you have D minor chord, and so on. To create a diminished chord, we actually have to pitch the top note one semitone down. So now we have a C minor diminished chord when we press C. Okay, so that's all we need inside the scale of C major to create all the chords of C major. So we can go to Google now here and actually look up for major chord sequence. So a major scale has multiple chords inside the scale. And the sequence is major, minor, minor, major, major, minor, diminished. If you go down here to C, you can see the first chord is a C major. And this is obvious because it's a C major scale, and the first chord in C major scale is of course a C major chord. So, but the second chord here, D, is a D minor, okay? So we have to switch up some values here to create this chord sequence. So we use the new Pitch 12 modulator. And when we press C, you can see this handle here is lighting up. We don't have to change anything because it's already major, a C major chord. But the second note, when we press D here, we also have a D major chord, but we need a D minor chord. So I'm using this handle and pitch the middle note one semitone down. And now we have a D minor chord. If you press C again, we have C major. If you press D, we have D minor. So dependent on the input note, we have different modulations for different keys to change the multi-note device to have the fitting chord as an output. So the next one is E, which is also a minor chord. Because think about it, we have major, minor, minor, major, major, minor, diminished, okay? So the next one here is the F, which is a major again. And we don't need to change anything because we already have the default setting at major. Also G is also major. Then we have A, we have diminished again. So let's pitch this down here, one semitone. And the last chord in the progression is the B, which is diminished. So we need to pitch down this one semitone, and also this one semitone. So the C major scale is pretty easy because you just need all the white keys on your keyboard when you start at C. So when we start at C here and press all the white keys up until the next C, we have all chords inside the C major scale just created with the multi-note and, yeah, four modulations, I think. So this is nothing you couldn't create before, because all you had to do is add a diatonic transposer and select major and C, and this diatonic transposer basically constrains all your notes to the C major scale, and you could create all chords this way. But the problem was, if you wanted to change some chords in your sequence, then this could be a problem. But you can solve this now with the pitch 12, because you can say, well, this G major here, I want to exchange this for the parallel chord in the minor scale. So we have C major scale, and then we take this chord from the same note, but from the minor scale. So if we look up here, minor chord progressions, it's a different, it's basically a different sequence. So we have minor, diminished, major, minor, minor, major, major, and so on. So we are on G in the major chords, in the major scale, which is G major, and we go to the minor chord progressions here and look at C and G, and it should be a minor. So let's change this up here. Press G, take the handle, and also pull this down. So now we have all the chords from C major, but one chord we've taken from the parallel minor chord to our chord progression. So that's already something interesting happening. The next thing we can do is we actually can switch this up. This four semitones line here, we can take it one octave higher. So instead of four, we're using 16, because zero and four, or we go 12 and four up is 16. So now we are on the same note, but one octave above, which already sounds more interesting. So let's press C. Okay. So now all notes are pretty much more far apart than before, and it sounds more interesting because you have more frequencies spread out across your song, right? As you can see on the on-screen display, when we go back to four, our notes are pretty close to each other. We go back to 16. They're spread more on the keyboard, so it sounds more interesting, right? So this is something you can do. So the next thing we can do is to apply some math and use inversions to actually group chords closer together, so the changes between them are not so drastic anymore. So for instance, look at our first chord here in the Visual Keyboard, and the last chord, which is the B diminished, they are pretty far apart. So our mission is now to bring them closer together. And we can do this by shifting some of the notes octave-wise around. So the first chord is here, and all we have to do is look at the last note here. If the last note is getting too close to the next C, the next octave, then we switch it back one octave. Okay, so let's go to D. It's okay. E. You can see the last note is nearly on the C here from the next octave. So we take this handle and just track our last note 12 semitones down. So it's the same key then, but one octave down. Okay, so if you compare this to the first chord, it's basically the same chord, just the root note is one semitone lower. Which instantly make them sound better together, because they are more close. Pretty easy stuff. So the next chord is the F. You can see the last note of F is hitting C here. So let's pitch the last note 12 semitones down. So sounds immediately better. And yeah, go on with G. The G major is actually already here on the D from the next octave. So let's also pull this 12 semitones down. Then we have the A. And A is the last note in E here. And we also pitch down this one here because it's a minor chord. So let's pull just this one down, 12 semitones. So now we are using the E note one octave lower. And you can see the second note here, which is a plus four or plus three, because we pitched this one semitone down, is also on the C, and we take it also one octave down. So we have also minus one here. So we need to modulate this minus 13. Then as a diminished chord here, we have also here minus one and also here minus one. So take this back one octave, you have to use minus 13. So now we have all the same chord progressions as before, just closer together. Okay, and now we can apply the same trick as before. We can use, instead of plus four, we can use plus 16. And it sounds much better because all the notes are closer together inside the sequence. So these are tricks you can do with the pitch 12 modulator and the multi-note. And there is, of course, a small bug because it's still in beta, but I will file a ticket about this, and I think it will be fixed before the release. And the bug is, I think, has to do with some kind of race condition. So sometimes the modulation is not applied correctly in time before the note is outputting or the device is outputting notes. So you can see sometimes when you press notes too fast, the modulation is not applied correctly. So this is a bug, and I will file something about it or write an email to Bitwig, and this will get fixed, I think, before the release. Yeah, that's it for this video. I try to explain everything pretty clear and slowly. If you have some feedback for me, do I need to go slower or be more precise in certain things, let me know. Also, subscribe to the channel, hit the small bell thing so you get a notification when I upload a new video. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I see you in the next video. Bye.